It began with war. Striking at the Outer Rim, the Mandalorian clans went to war with the Republic. It was a long and brutal struggle, yet despite the pleas of the Senate, the Jedi refused to get involved. Feeling the cries of innocent deaths through the Force, two Jedi Knights, Revan and Malak, chose to ignore the will of the Council and intervene in the war, bringing with them many Jedi who were sympathetic to the Republic's needs. With Revan leading the charge, the war began to turn in the Republic's favor until finally, at Malachor V, the Mandalorians were defeated. But Revan and Malak were changed. They disappeared with much of the great army of the Jedi and Republic soldiers that had defeated the threat, escaping into the unknown regions. They returned as Sith, corrupted by the dark side, ready to wage war on a fragile Republic and stagnant Jedi Order. The strongest shall lead. That is the way of the Sith, and so it was inevitable that Malak would turn on Revan. When that happened, Revan was destroyed, and Malak set about decimating the Republic. But the dark side is nothing more than a corruption of the Force. For every dark threat, there is a beacon of light to oppose it. High above the planet Terrace, the hands of destiny were in play, working to bring a Republic soldier, Logan Starr, and a gifted Jedi named Bastila Shan together. Even as Logan and a decorated hero, Cartho Nassi, crashed on the occupied world below, fate appeared to be guiding them towards Bastila. Allies became a valuable asset on a world under the control of the Sith. Together with a Mandalorian, a young Twi'lek, and an 8-foot-tall Wookiee, Logan and Carth managed to free Bastila and escape Terrace as Darth Malak lay to waste its surface. No one is sure how the Force works. Not even the Jedi Council. When Logan Starr appeared before them on the sanctuary world of Dantooine, his connection to the Force seemed to surprise even the wisest of masters. Yet his connection to Bastila was even more profound. Together they saw visions of the past, of the journey Malak and his master Revan undertook as they fell into darkness. So the Jedi decided to train Logan in the ways of the Force, to teach him compassion and restraint, to guide him towards his destiny. One he shared with Bastila. Together they would follow the path of Revan and Malak and hope to find a way to end the war and stop the Sith. The first clue to the Sith's power came on Dantooine itself. Ancient ruins held the secrets of an old and forgotten race. A rundown droid spoke of a star forge, and a star map showed the way. But one was not enough. To follow the paths of Revan, the Jedi would need to find each star map hidden across four other worlds. The Sith had plans of their own. Kallo Nord, a bounty hunter and survivor of the destruction of Terrace, found himself gaining an audience with the Dark Lord of the Sith. Having encountered Bastila and Logan on the destroyed world, Kallo, a rival of Kandaris, was eager for another encounter and, with the blessing of the Sith, set about tracking down his adversaries. For Logan Starr, the journey that began on Terrace now led him to Kashyyyk, home of the towering Wookiees. It was a world enslaved by corporate greed and traitorous sons. Zerka Corporation, who had ties to the Exchange, had no feelings of remorse as they sent Wookiee slaves to the far reaches of the galaxy and plundered their homeworld for resources. For Logan's Wookiee allies Albar, though, it was about something more. It was about the blood of his family, the loyalty of his tribe, something lost on his brother Tundar, who openly helped keep the tribes from revolting against Zerka. The jungle world of Kashyyyk is full of dangers, betrayals and surprises, and when Logan discovered an old Jedi living in the dark corners of the Shadowlands, the truth of Tundar's betrayals came to light. An old and broken Wookiee, Freyr, father of both Zalbar and Tundar, had been cast out of the tribe and sent to the Shadowlands to live with insanity before death. As Logan and his companions found the star map hidden in the jungle, Freyr found that his will to set things right remained, and with these new allies, he had the strength to stand before his fallen son and restore pride to his people. With his father and brother Zalbar standing against him, Tundar, consumed by the power Zerka had given him, fought to the bitter end, his death the first in a rebellion. The Wookiees had rediscovered their strength, their will to be free, and without Chundar holding them back, keeping them tamed, they turned on their masters, and Zirka, for all their wealth, were powerless against the might of the Wookiee tribes. But as the Wookiees fought for their freedom high in the trees, down below, in the Shadowlands, Kalo-Nord waited for his prey, and as the eyes of the jungle watched, face to face, Kalo and Logan fought intensely until the Jedi, guided by the Force, struck down his enemy. The Wookiees were victorious, their people freed. Visions of death, of the past and future, haunted Logan's dreams as Malak, determined to capture Bastila, stood on the bridge of his flagship, planning his next move. On Kashyyyk, though, the troubles of war were forgotten for one night as the Wookiees celebrated freedom and Logan pondered the future. They would soon leave the jungle world with a small victory, but with their fates unclear, their futures uncertain, the veil of the dark side would soon fall.
Kalo-Nord is dead, Lord Malak. He has failed in his mission. Forgive me.
The penalty for failure is death, Admiral Carath. But the failure was Kalo's, not yours. You may rise.
Shall I hire another bounty hunter, Lord Malak?
No mere bounty hunter can stand against a Jedi. I shall not make the same mistake again. My apprentice, Darth Bandon, shall take care of our young Jedi friend.
As you command, Master.
Thank you.
bad feeling about this. Captain Seth Drace, do you copy? Logan Starr to Captain Drace, come in.
Yes, Logan, we read you. What's the status?
We've successfully infiltrated the Sith base, and they're quite aware of our presence.
Perfect, that's what we want. All of the efforts will be focused on you two while the T3 droid does its work and acquires the data.
Hold that thought, Captain. As you can see, Captain, we don't have all the time in the world.
Yes, Logan. This is our only shot. You know what's at stake.
Yes. Logan Starr out. Now let's just hope that Zabrak on Telos was right. And that little droid does its job. Bastila, maybe there's more to our Force bond than I had originally thought.
I hardly think the Force would be pushing us toward a romantic involvement when the fate of the galaxy is at stake.
Look, I'm just saying.
I doubt the Council would approve if they knew we were busy discussing our mutual attraction when
mutual
we should be...
attraction? So there is something there.
Mutual attraction? I never said... It's just an expression.
Mutual attraction, huh? This is where the fun begins. He's got the codes. Bring the Hawk in, guys. We're on our way to the droid.
Well, I guess I should be at least a little pleased that I haven't lost my touch.
Fair enough. Let's move on.
T3, please, an update.
T3, we don't have much time.
So, about this mutual attraction.
I'm simply trying to help you and complete this mission, and yet you battle me at every turn.
Just having a little fun. Come on, let's stop here.
Fun? Fun? Driving me insane is your idea of a good time?
How about a little self-control there, Master Jedi?
You are a very odd man. Do you know that?
All right, they're here. Now we just gotta find our little buddy.
I don't know if I should be outraged that you keep joking about serious matters, or if I should be grateful that you can always lighten the mood.
I think that's T3. Come on. Impressive, T3. Let's go.
Thank you. I like the way you handled that. Are you sure you don't have some Mandalorian blood in you?
The Sith presence on Manon is quite extensive. However, we were able to retrieve the star map with minimal casualties. Sort of.
Is there anything else then?
We've taken on supplies and are ready to leave for Tatooine, with your permission.
May the Force be with you in this quest.
No. Wait. There is something I must know. I must know about Revan.
Your primary task takes precedence.
If I'm to help defeat Malak, I must know. I'm going where he went, finding what he found. Revan fell. And if I'm to avoid that fate, I must know what he did.
The easy lure of the dark side is difficult to resist, and I fear this quest to find this mysterious star forge will lead you down an all too familiar path.
No one is denying that Revan was one of the keys to defeating the Mandalorians. But something happened out there on the Outer Rim. Instead of returning after the war's end, the ships under Revan's command went deep into unexplored space. They claimed to be searching for the last remnants of the Mandalorian fleet. All contact was lost. For many months, it was assumed some great disaster had befallen the entire fleet. Everyone thought they were dead. 3 years ago, Revan and Malak returned at the head of a massive invasion fleet. Revan had assumed the title of Sith Lord. The hero had become a conqueror.
I knew Revan as a promising young pupil. Revan was strong in the Force, but also headstrong and proud.
It's so easy to think that we would never fall prey to such a horror.
Yes.
That we have unlimited control, vigilance, and foresight. If only that were true. The Sith have become powerful because there are many Jedi who've succumbed to the lure of the dark side and joined their cause. What greater weapon is there than to turn an enemy to your cause, to use their own knowledge against them?
Revan's tale shows us how even the greatest of Jedi can fall to the dark side.
Yes, I see it now.
You have a mission to attend to, Padawan.
May the Force be with you in your quest.
I pray both you and Bastilla are able to emerge from this ordeal as servants of the light. May the Force be with you.
The clans as they were aren't a threat, but the galaxy still fears us. People think we war out of spite or bloodlust. They don't understand and fear that.
Excellent. So Jolie had no trouble catching up with her after all. What's the news? A woman, huh? Well, let's hang on to that message and we'll give it to her on the ship.
We've got work to do, so let's get to it. What? You think I don't have something better to do?
Remember this spot? We've shared this sunset before.
Yes.
We've shared many sunsets lately on different worlds. But the one that's supposed to feel the safest, somehow to me feels the least assuring.
There is something I would like to ask, if you'll permit it. I wasn't even going to say anything. You are a true servant of the light. You follow the tenets of the Jedi Order despite the lure of the dark side. And with so little training, for me it has always been a constant battle. Don't you find it difficult at all?
Yes, I too get angry. Somehow for me it almost feels natural or familiar. But that doesn't make it right, does it?
I don't know. Would the power I used to kill Darth Malak be too tempting to keep using? Would I become the kind of evil I want to destroy? The very thought that I could become as evil as Malak, I just can't fathom it. It just doesn't seem possible. I mean, how could I... No. Wait, I'm sorry. I shouldn't even be asking you this. The Jedi teachings are clear. These are dangerous thoughts. The indulgence of a vain mind. Please, forget I ever mentioned this. Let's just return to our mission.
Transport bound for Tatooine.
How did you acquire this information?
I was very persuasive with the docking bay security unit. It'll take some time for me to recover their tracks.
Very well.
This Basila you speak of, Master, she has friends, more than a few.
This is not unexpected. Deal with them.
Is this a good idea, Master? Trailing this insignificant group just to...
Question my orders, and I will destroy you. You are my apprentice. You are eager for blood, as am I. Understand. Feed on the Jedi. Feed on the dark side that is within all of us.
Yes, my master.
You are dismissed.
Thought I'd come out to the Outer Rim.
Tatooine's just a desert planet.
I can't imagine anything of galactic importance happening way out here.
Tatooine is a dry planet that has not been inhabited long and has little law.
That's because it's controlled by the Hutts. Steady as she goes, Karth. I see the colony ahead.
Mission, Jolie. Good to see you.
Hey there.
How's Tatooine?
Nothing but a rock covered by a bunch of worthless sand.
That bad, huh?
Unless you're one of the local species and end up being slaughtered or enslaved, Tatooine's a nice enough desert.
Mm-hmm.
Jolie, may I have a moment? There's something I wish to speak to you about.
Yep, I figured it was only a matter of time until we had the whole come back to the order discussion. Well, I guess there's no avoiding it now, so let's get it over with.
I know you have issues with the Order, but you are a Jedi, Jolie. You command the Force. Without the guidance of the Council, how can you avoid falling to the dark side?
Well, I've managed to avoid it the last 20 years or so. Besides, light side, dark side, they don't mean the same to me as they do to you. I don't see in absolutes. I want to stop Malak as much as anyone. But I don't have to join the Order to do it. The capacity for good or evil, like the Force itself, is in all living creatures. And belonging to the Jedi Order, or the Sith, or any group, won't change what you are at your core.
I see you are quite adamant. No doubt you've had ample time to think on this during your long seclusion. I guess it was foolish of me to think I could sway your position so easily.
I need to walk. I sense something that I...
Yeah, I'm old and stubborn. But I appreciate the effort. But from now on, you can just think of me as any other non-Jedi in our little group. With a lightsaber. And Force powers.
What?
Are you kidding? First you ask about it, and then you say you don't want to hear it? You're as bad as my brother used to be.
Lord Malak was most displeased when he learned you had escaped Taris alive. He has promised a great reward to whoever destroys you.
Leave him alone, you core slimes!
I knew it. I do sense something. I think I'm close.
I knew I could count on you.
Hey. Why don't you try attacking me this time? You guys okay? Anyone care for a drink? Sorry it took me so long, guys. Minor annoyance. This music is terrible. Frankly, I prefer the music on Terrace to this. Oh, quiet over there. Something on your mind? You're thinking about Saul, aren't you?
I don't talk about it very much, okay? I told you about my homeworld, Telos. 4 years ago, Saul led the Sith fleet there and demanded its surrender. The planet refused, and Saul proceeded to devastate its entire surface. Millions died. I had a wife and a son on Telos. I thought they would be safe there, but my task force arrived too late to be of much help. We didn't have enough medical supplies. The colony was burning and the dying were everywhere. I remember holding my wife and screaming for the medics, but they didn't come in time.
Wow, Karth, I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Of course not. How could you? I had nothing left after that, really. I devoted myself to the fleet. Hunting Saul was my only purpose. I miss them, and I know killing Saul won't bring them back. And it won't make me happy again, but I have to do it. I don't expect you to understand, but I have to pay him back for what he's done. I have to. It's all I have left.
Sorry, Karth.
Let's continue with what we were doing.
You got it. Now this music's more like it. Let's find Bastila. She should be somewhere here in the lower level looking for her mother. There she is. Looks like she found her. You guys go back to the ship.
And him. Don't you recognize me? What do you expect when I haven't so much as had a picture of you since you left? You knew as well as I communication would be impossible once I joined the Order. Now what is this about? Where is Father?
Then you haven't heard. I should have known.
Has something happened to him? Are you going to tell me or not?
Your father is dead, Bastila. That is part of the reason why I was looking for you.
Dead? What happened? What did you do to him?
Isn't this a lovely reunion? Already she's flinging insults at me. Tell me, you're one of her friends. Do you treat your mother this way?
My mother is long dead, if you must know.
Well, I'll be joining her soon enough, I suppose.
I was told you were sick. Are you actually dying, or is this merely a melodrama for my benefit?
Bastila, easy.
Such sweet things, you say. You want me to tell you I brought your father here for an expedition, do you? You want to blame me for his death? You never accepted that your father loved going on his treasure hunts, leaving you alone with me. I was always to blame for everything. He took an expedition into the Tatooine Desert, and he died.
How can you be sure of that? Father is an experienced...
Do you think I would look for you if I wasn't sure? They were attacked by a Krayt dragon, and one of the guides fled the battle. He saw your father killed.
I see. So what do you want from me? Credits?
You don't be insulting. I want you to use those senses of yours. I want you to find him. I want you to bring back his holocron.
Why? So you can sell it?
Bastila.
Is it too much to ask that I have something to remember your father by?
Well, maybe we should help her. When Bastila, she said she's dying.
It doesn't seem to have anything to do with what she's asking. Are you actually sick, Mother?
What difference does it make to you? None, I'm sure. Just find your father's holocron, and you won't have to worry about me again either way.
That's the kind of response I would expect. Very well. We'll look for the holocron if we have time. I can't promise any more than that.
Bastila. You all right? You want to talk about it?
About my mother? I'm unsure. I seem to find it difficult to remain objective when it comes to her. I find that disturbing.
No. You don't think we should look for your father's holocron?
We've more important things to do. Still, my father is dead. Just because we find the holocron doesn't mean I have to give it to her.
That's dangerous ground. What's on there anyway?
Father recorded all his personal thoughts in that holocron, even when I knew him. Having it would be like having him with you. I don't see why she deserves it, however. She drove him to his death. I loved him, and I didn't even have a chance to say goodbye. That leaves a hurt inside you just can't imagine. I haven't seen him in so long.
Bastila, I just
really don't
want
to think about this. Please, let's just keep going.
Right.
Hi, nice little shop you've got here. Okay. I'm in the market for a translator droid. Ideally all languages, but to be specific, the language of the Tuskens.
Greeting! Hello to you, prospective purchaser. I am referred to as HK-47. A fully functional Sci-Tech Corporation droid skilled in both combat and protocol functions. Query, would you be so kind as to purchase this model from Yukalaka? It would serve my purposes to be removed from his ownership.
No kidding. So outline your functions.
Answer, it is sufficient to say that I am a fully capable translator and cultural analyst. And I am also proficient in personal combat.
Personal combat?
I am not dangerous, you bucket of bolts. That is, it is rare that I am able to utilize my full array of abilities. You seem likely to give me the opportunity to do so.
So I take it you're not just a translator droid, huh?
Statement. My functions are wasted here, prospective purchaser. But I assure you, I am better utilized elsewhere.
Well, he doesn't seem to like you. Shocking.
And if the unit proves even more uncooperative once we purchase it...
Fine. Just name your price.
Statement. I find this a satisfactory arrangement.
Where's T3? T3, stop flirting and let's get out of here.
With Karth and T3 on the Hawk making repairs, the ship should be ready to go by the time we find the star map.
Trips out in the desert, especially the deep desert, should be taken very carefully.
The star map would likely have to be within some kind of shelter to protect it against dust and sandstorms.
Well, in any event, all we have to do now is wait for our sandcrawler to... It's one of Voga's sandcrawlers. Looks like we'll have to come to them. Let's go.
I'd say you guys could use a little help, but it seems like you've fended them off yourselves.
Oh, I'd say that's not the last of them. Here they come.
Well, we know what to do, guys. Those creatures are tougher than I had expected. I'm Logan Starr. I believe you were scheduled to pick us up?
Indeed we were. As you can see, we got a little tied up. I'm Bria Hudson, captain of the Lady Luck. This here's Slug, first mate.
Howdy.
Nice to meet you both. Seems your group couldn't put up a fight.
I wish that were so. But their surprise attack took out half of us. Another sandcrawler is on the way to take you to your destination. No disrespect, but you guys are crazy for thinking you can just waltz your way into the Tusken Enclave.
Well, we've got a translator droid here to help us.
They're mindless beasts, Mr. Logan.
Well, I'll be the judge of that.
Though it may be a good idea to grab some of these Tusken robes and masks to make entry a little easier.
Well, let us help you clean up a little bit around here.
Thank you, Mr. Logan.
Hey, Bastila. You ever use the Force just for fun? You know, a little jolt of the Force to trip up some jerk who's ticking you off?
I would never use the Force for such petty and trivial revenge. The mere thought of it's preposterous.
Don't be so stuck up. You can tell me.
I am not stuck up. I merely have the years of training to give me the wisdom and understanding to see how childish such an act would be.
Childish? Is that a crack about my age? You ain't much older than me, Miss High and Mighty. Just because you're some Jedi, doesn't mean you can be a prissy little... What the... Hey! That wasn't funny!
HK-47 is ready to serve, Master.
You know, you don't have to call me Master, HK.
Query, don't I? I was under the assumption that organic meatbags such as yourself enjoyed such forms of address.
Sure. Bria!
Mr. Logan, your crawler will be here momentarily.
Good. Let's gather the others and then we'll head out.
Skandaris, you fought in the Mandalorian Wars. Tell me about Revan. Surely you faced him.
Revan was a genius on the field. There was no one else. I still remember that final battle in the skies above Malachor V. The two fleets filling the space around it, outshining the stars. It was not your ships, or your men, or your vaunted fight for freedom that won this, the final battle of the war. It was by the actions of one person, the Jedi Revan, that you prevailed.
You really do credit this one man.
His strategies and tactics defeated the best of us. Even Mandalore himself was taken aback by the ferocity of his attacks, the tenacity of his defenses, and the subtleties of his plans.
You suffered heavy casualties, did you not? Nearly your entire army.
Yeah. There weren't many of us after that last battle.
Yet you praise the man that crushed your people.
I don't hold a grudge against Revan, and neither do any of my people. It was the greatest moment of my life to be in that battle.
The war is over and Revan is long dead. This galaxy still feels the consequences from his rule. And now we have Malak.
Agreement. This was my thought as well, Master. You show excellent logical skills for a meatbag.
You know, I'm starting to wish they had a wider selection of droids.
Come on, you have to admit. Looks pretty intimidating, right?
Must be so frustrating.
Right, just trying to get my mind off the fact that these suits are so damn uncomfortable.
Come on, come. Let's move on. There's much to be done.
The world of my clan, Ordo, was much like this. Dust basins and rock crags. But my world at least has some green around the equator.
Yeah, I could definitely go for a vacation on Naboo right about now.
Yeah.
Look natural, people. Hey, Bastila.
How can I help?
I'm gonna take the lead here. I think we should be a little more cautious. Something feels off.
Can I suggest we move on?
So I guess we'll just walk right on in. This doesn't feel like a good idea at all. Looks like we have a welcoming committee.
Interjection. One moment. I believe I understood that, Master.
Quickly, tell him we're not a threat.
Translation.
Is this seriously the way we're gonna communicate with these people?
I would much rather this get bloody, Master, but it is your call.
Finally, they see us. Okay, we've been had. They've kept us here till nearly sundown. HK, communicate with them. Find out what they want.
Translation. I can translate with some guarantee of accuracy that he is demanding to know why he should let us survive this encounter, Master.
If they wanted us dead, they would have killed us already, HK. Tell them we want to negotiate a peaceful end to the attacks on Voga's miners.
Translation. He says that will never happen, Master. Ignorant outsiders continually desecrate their most reverential customs.
And I understand that, but we're alive for a reason. They have to want something. Ask them how we can meet them in the middle.
Translation. He requires proof of good faith. We must make a contribution to his people that shows we are not a threat. Shall I blast him now, Master?
Okay, how do we prove we're worthy?
Translation. The greatest challenge for a warrior is to face a great dragon, the largest predator on Tatooine. Fight one of those.
No wonder they kept us alive. They want us to do their dirty work. Well, at least Voga mentioned something about the star map being in a cave, so we're headed there.
Translation. His people found it, but didn't scavenge it because a crate dragon took up residence in the excavation.
So the star map's there. Finally some good news.
Disgust? I think he's making fun of you, Master. He doesn't believe an outsider could do such a thing.
Oh, he'll find I'm full of surprises.
Have you lost your nerve?
I don't believe this. We've been after this dragon for so long. Yet there you stand, Komet, idly by.
There's the cave. Looks like someone's already down there. How would they know?
How can you be so fearful?
There it lurks, before us, in the darkness. Eternal glory!
Fine, I will go in alone. That guy's not crazy enough to go in with just a blaster.
Tired of waiting for you, Comad. I will slay the dragon myself and claim the glory as my own.
Bah, coward.
What is he doing? No. We should help. I must get in there.
Ita hodonga.
So that's it then. I need something in there.
Gakun Hokami. One kun bees ching palamule tunking banodak.
Such as?
Chikun ita hodonga. Ye king kuno.
Wait, the crate dragon hunts banthas, correct?
Bamule rachikun. Spimo podona.
Let's do work. Come along now. Let's go. All too easy. Very good. I think it's showtime. Here it comes, it's moving. There it is. The star map. Here it comes.
Statement. I believe there can be little doubt that we have found the star map you were seeking. I am surprised it is still working after all this time.
Anybody else get the feeling that finding this star map in the back of this crate dragon's cave is more than just a coincidence?
I do not think it is mere chance that we have found the star map here, in the lair of a crate dragon.
Yes, it would seem a little too convenient.
The star map is an artifact of the dark side. The crate dragon may have been drawn here by its dark power, only to be enslaved by it.
Hey, look at that. Bastila, it's your father's holocron.
Now that we've got what we came for, we should probably move on. Can't say I'm going to miss this pit of the world.
There's a problem with the uplink. See what you can do with it, HK.
Yes, Master.
Bastila? What is it?
There you are. You've kept me waiting long enough.
You guys just don't give up, do you? How many do I have to kill before you get the message?
I am no Dark Jedi. I am Darth Bandon, sole apprentice to Lord Malak himself.
Kandarus, stay back. Guard the star map until HK has finished downloading the data. We'll deal with the Sith.
Deal with us. You may have bested the bounty hunter and a few dark Jedi, but you are no match for the power of a Sith Lord.
We'll see about that. HK, hurry with that star map.
As you desire, Master. There is tremendous power emanating from the star map.
What's the matter? Don't like the odds?
Such arrogance.
You're outmatched and outclassed, Sith.
You underestimate my power.
Didn't mean to cut you off. I didn't like his tone.
Back already?
I have the holocron, Mother. I'm just not sure I want to give it to you. You may think I don't remember what it was like before I left for the Order, but I do. You were eager to send me to the Jedi, even though I didn't want to go. You took Father away from me. And now this holocron is all I have of him. It's time we parted ways now, for both our benefit.
Bastila, are you sure about this?
Why should she have the holocron?
Is it too difficult to believe that I am a dying woman who simply wishes to see her husband one last time?
Bastila, you're better than this.
You're right. It shames me, but I find it difficult to let go of the past.
I was hard on you, dear. I wasn't a very good mother to you. It was a reckless life we led. Always moving. I didn't want that for you.
So that's why you gave me to the Order.
What do your father and I have to show for all those years of hunting? Nothing. That was no life for anyone, your father. He spent all his last years trying to pay for my treatments.
Your treatments?
I'm dying, Master. I did not lie about that. It's been a long time in the coming, and there's really nothing that can be done anymore. I told your father to let me go.
I'm so sorry, Mother. I don't know what to say.
Keep the hologram, Gastela. It would do me good to know you have it. This talking to you, this is what I really needed before I...
I know. Thank you. I'm glad we talked too.
You there. You take care of my daughter, you hear me?
Yes. You have my word.
You do what you have to, Bastila. You go make your father and I proud.
I'll try. Farewell, Mother.
I'm proud of you, Bastila. You did the right thing.
That brought me a lot of peace. More than I thought it would have.
Well, perhaps now you've found the closure with your mother that you've long needed.
Thank you for urging me toward it. After all my training, I would have thought it would have been easier. Apparently, I still have much to learn. The fact of the matter is, I have never possessed much skill at controlling myself. With the bond that joins us, it seems I have even less.
That's not true. You did good here.
That's a kinder response than I deserve. And I can see there is wisdom in your words. You continue to be there for me, don't you? Even after I keep pushing you away, you're still around when I need you most. I need time to think about all this. Things have... they're not going as I thought they would. You're like no man I've known before.
Thank you.
stronger than I am, and there's no point in telling me otherwise. In some ways, you make me feel weak, like I'm caught up in the wake of our destiny. But at the same time, you make me feel stronger, more alive.
Yes, I feel that too.
I realize now these feelings are part of the bond we share.
Why would we deny this?
Don't you realize how difficult this was for me?
Difficult for you?
Why do you think I came to this decision? I know how hard this is for both of us.
My destiny leads to Malak, Vesla. And I want you there by my side, not as a mentor, as something more.
You mean it, don't you? But how can I be sure you're not making a mistake? I have to resist.
But you don't have to resist.
But I don't... I mean, I can't. We shouldn't have done that. It was wrong. The Jedi are not allowed to fall in love.
But it's how we handle that love. That's the measure of who we are.
It was a moment of weakness when I kissed you. We shouldn't have. I'm sorry. No, I know we both wanted it, but we shouldn't have given in to our desire. We're Jedi. We can't act like this. Not now. I'm sorry. I don't blame you, but it was a mistake. I have to get out of here before somebody sees us together.
Vastala. Damn it. What was that? The ship.
What happened? What's going on?
Sith interdictor ship. They must have been waiting for us on the hyperspace route.
Well, let's just turn on the speed.
We're caught in their tractor beam.
Blast. We gotta do something.
Do you recognize the ship?
Wait a minute. That looks like the ship that was over Terrace.
It's the Leviathan. Saul Carath's vessel.
Saul Carath? You mean your old mentor?
My old mentor.
Look alive, people. It's about to get interesting.
Chance to kill Saul during our escape. Nobody better get in my way.
Talk of an escape is somewhat premature, don't you think? We don't even have a plan to get out of this mess yet.
Saul's no fool, and he won't underestimate us either. You can count on plenty of guards watching every move we make.
Maybe Admiral Carath doesn't know how many of us there are on board. We all have special talents. Talents we could exploit so that one of us could stage a rescue.
Yes, I like that.
It's a long shot, but it's our only hope.
I think it should be me.
The Admiral will be watching the three of us far too closely for any plot involving you, me, or Carth to succeed. It's going to be up to one of the others to get us out of this.
Well, if we're gonna pick someone to save our skins, we better do it quick. In another minute, we're gonna have Sith troops marching up our loading ramp.
Maybe I can goad the guards into making a mistake. If I get them mad enough, they might put me in a separate cell to punish me. With them focusing so much on you three, I might be able to sneak out of my cell and come rescue the rest of you. It's a risk we have to take, Big Z. I can slice my way free of any security cell. Don't worry, I can pull this off.
That is possible.
Well, you are the only one who's good at slicing computers. I guess we have no other choice.
I won't let you down. You'll see.
Bastila, Carth, and the crew have been taken prisoner as you ordered, Commander.
Excellent. Have you searched the ship thoroughly? Admiral Carath warned me to be on alert for any kind of treachery.
We found a young Twi'lek in the back. She's got quite the mouth on her. She swore at me and spit on my uniform. She tried to bite me through my armor, and you should hear what she said about my mother. Admiral Carath needs to teach her the proper respect for the Sith.
The Admiral doesn't have time to bother with some Twi'lek girl. Take her away to solitary confinement. I'll leave it up to you to teach her the proper respect for the Sith.
Carth, it has been far too long since we last spoke. I see the recent months have not been kind in your case. I barely recognized you.
But I recognize you, Saul.
I see your face every night, even as I promise myself I will kill you for what you did to my homeworld.
Did you learn nothing in your time under me? As a soldier, you should understand that casualties were unavoidable. This was an act of war.
It was a cowardly act of betrayal. Your fleet bombed a civilian target into oblivion without warning or provocation, and the blood of those innocent people is on your hands.
In war, even the innocent must die.
My wife died in that attack, Saul. And for that, I swear I'll kill you.
Cling to your lust for revenge if you must, but spare me your tired threats. I've heard them all before. Enough. I don't want them to pass out before I question them. Malik will appreciate any information I can give him when he arrives.
Don't waste your breath, Saul. We won't answer any of your questions.
I'm sure you won't. However, we both know your friend's loyalties have proven in the past to be somewhat flexible. It is time to put your loyalty to the test. I doubt torturing you will gain me your true cooperation. However, even the strongest of heroes has trouble watching those they care about suffer.
Saul, please stop. Don't hurt her.
My pain is meaningless. Tell him nothing.
On what planet is the Jedi Academy at which you were trained?
What? Alderaan. It's on Alderaan.
Alderaan is nothing but a planet of artisans and philosophers. There is no training academy there. This is the price of your resistance.
No. No! Pain!
No, best luck.
Enough. You see what happens when you try to defy me. Obviously, Malik knew the Academy was on Dantooine, and it has since been destroyed by our fleet.
That's a lie.
Dantooine is an empty graveyard now. Nothing is there but a smoking ruin and the charred remains of your former masters.
Then I will avenge them with your head. It'll look nice next to Darth Bandon's.
I see I'm wasting my time here. When Malik arrives, you will learn my interrogation techniques are considered merciful among the Sith.
Asla, you okay?
Don't try to move too quickly. You might not be fully recovered yet.
Saul will pay for this.
He's become some sort of sadistic monster.
The dark side has perverted him, Karth. Once you start down the tainted path, it leads you ever further into the depths of evil. First Taras, now the Academy. Is there no end to the killing?
Maybe he was lying.
I'd like to believe that Saul was lying to us. But even as he said the words, I knew they were true. The Academy is gone. I can only hope that some of the Jedi escaped. Rook, Vendar, Saar. I cannot imagine all of them being gone.
None of this will matter if we don't get out of this prison before Saul gets back.
It is fortunate you were able to resist the Admiral's questioning.
Watching you suffer tore me apart, Bastila. I felt an anger that I haven't felt.
I have to confess something. There was a moment, just a moment, when part of me was hoping you would tell him what he wanted to know. I don't honestly know if I could have been as strong in your position. To watch you suffer like that, it might have been too much for me to bear. Did you feel that? A disturbance in the Force. The Admiral has sent his message. The Dark Lord knows we are here now. Malik is coming.
Well, then we better hope...
Don't worry, Karth. Mission will do her duty.
Come on, girly. Into the cell. Let's go. I haven't got all day to waste on you. I need to get back to my post.
Quit crowding me. Sheesh. Megamorians didn't smell as bad as you said.
You think you're pretty funny, don't you? But you're only making things worse for yourself.
How come every time you open your mouth to talk, the scent of rancor dung comes out?
Maybe a little time in solitary confinement will teach you the proper respect for the Sith. Now get into that cell.
Who designed those Sith uniforms anyway? A blind Rodian with a sick sense of humor?
No, that's funny. You should tell that one to the torturer when he comes to deal with you.
What? You're going to torture me?
No snappy comeback this time. The thought of torture scares you, hmm? Well, it should. The Sith have ways to inflict pain you can't even imagine. It may be a few hours before your torture begins. We're busy interrogating your friends right now. Hey, I know. You could use this time to think up witty ways to beg for mercy.
Or I could use the keycard I lifted from your pocket to slice into the security panel and get myself out of this cell. Piece of cake. wonder when people will stop underestimating me. Simple. Hurt.
Access and security clearance. Placing forward prisoner cells.
Darn it! Problem now.
Release enough prisoner cells.
Hey, back again.
Good job, Mission. I knew you wouldn't let us down. When we get out of this, I'm gonna see that you get a medal from the Republic for everything you've done. Now, if I remember the layout of the ship, our equipment should be in a storage chamber just through the north doors. The bridge is the only place that we can open the docking gates of the hangar where they've got the Ebon Hawk. We have to open those gates before we can fly out of here.
We better get moving. I can feel the darkness of Malik's presence approaching.
I'm not afraid of Malik.
Then you are a fool. The power of the Dark Lord is strong enough to destroy any of us. Even you.
Right. Well, then we need some sort of game plan. Any ideas?
A small group might have a better chance of sneaking onto the bridge undetected while the others make their way down to the Ebon Hawk.
Count me in, then. I've got a score to settle with the Admiral before we get off this ship.
Right. I'm with you both.
The rest of you head down to the docking hangar where they've got the Ebon Hawk. You'll have to find a way to deal with the guards.
Don't you worry about that. I know how to deal with the guards.
Seems awful quiet down here, doesn't it? I'm just saying.
Surprise! Check!
Here, hold up over here.
Damn!
It's an ambush. Candorous better be ready for it. Actually, they better be ready for Candorous.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
There are two walls for this.
This is what I live for.
Here it is!
Rise.
Come on, guys. We're almost to the bridge.
Okay, let's stick together.
Just a little bit further.
Sure. I'll humor you.
Let's see what you got.
Now you get it. So close.
Wait, I got this group.
That one's out of the way.
Moving on.
This is gonna be good.
This is Candorous. We're at the Ebon Hawk. Like we figured, it's under heavy guard. But don't worry. We'll figure out a plan to take care of them.
Well, this is it. This is the bridge. Karth, I'm right behind you. No mercy.
Very resourceful. I assume you had some part in this. You learned your lessons well from me.
The only thing you taught me was betrayal and death, Saul.
Don't be a fool. I'm giving you and your companions a chance to surrender, a chance to live. Darth Malak himself is on his way. He'll be arriving any moment.
He speaks the truth, Garth. I can feel the Dark Lord's presence approaching.
Let him approach. It's time to end this.
Malak will destroy you. But if you throw down your weapons now, I will ask my master to be merciful.
I've seen enough of Sith mercy.
You always did like to do things the hard way. Lord Malak would have preferred live prisoners, but corpses will have to do.
Down you go! Bessler, wait! On my way! Cover us. Bessler, over here. Now it's your turn. Karth, blast him.
Karth.
The Admiral. He's still alive.
It's time to finish this.
You're damn right it is. End this.
No, Karth. Not like this. Do not give in to the hate.
Don't you understand what this man has done to my life? Do you know the pain he's brought me?
Bastila, this man destroyed his homeworld, murdered his family.
Killing him won't ease the pain, Karth. Do not become what you despise.
Karth, must tell you something. Come closer. Remember my dying words. Whenever you look at those, you thought were your friends.
He's gone. I said, it can't be true, can it? No, it can't. Damn you. Saul.
What did he say?
Basil, it is true, isn't it? And you knew. You and the whole damn Jedi Council, you knew the whole time.
Karth, it's not what you think. We had no other choice. Please, you don't understand.
So make me understand.
Understand what? What are you guys talking about? Karth, tell me.
Not here, Karth. Please, there's no time. Malak is coming. This isn't the place. Please, Karth. I'm asking you to trust me for just a little while longer.
Fair enough. Come on, let's get out of here. Wait. Hold up here.
Darth Malak.
I hope you weren't thinking of leaving so soon, Bastila. I spent far too much energy hunting down you and your companions to let you get away from me now. Besides, I had to see for myself if it was true. Even now, I can hardly believe my eyes.
Well, I'm here, standing right in front of you, Malak.
You mean you don't know? All this time, and you still haven't figured it out.
I wonder how long you would have stayed blind to the truth.
What truth? You're speaking in riddles, Malak.
Surely some of what you once were must have surfaced by now.
The Council would not normally accept an adult for training. But this is a special case.
They said the Force can do terrible things to a mind. Can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity.
Primary neural recognition complete. Preliminary match found.
Match found?
Yes, you're very strong. I too get angry. Somehow for me, it almost feels natural, familiar.
The easy lure of the dark side is difficult to resist,
and I fear this quest to find this mysterious Star Forge will lead you down an all too familiar path.
I can sense the dark side. I feel it every day, begging for me to surrender to it.
What greater weapon is there than to turn an enemy to your cause, to use their own knowledge against them?
Strike team captured you, and the Council used the Force to reprogram your mind. They wiped away your identity and turned you against your own followers.
No, this can't be true. I couldn't be capable of that kind of... No.
You must have seen flashes of your old life in your dreams, Revan. Memories bubbling up to the surface.
Yes. Yes, I've seen them.
The Jedi are fools. They do not believe in executing prisoners.
It's true. I was part of the team sent to capture Revan, to capture you. When Malak fired on the ship, you were badly injured. We thought you were dead. Your mind was destroyed, but I used the Force to preserve the flicker of life in your body. I brought you to the Jedi Council. They were the ones who healed your damaged mind.
The Jedi Council didn't restore your wounded mind, Revan. They tried to make you their slave.
You've been lying to me this whole time, Bastila. How could you?
I wanted to tell you, but the Council forbid it. They were afraid you might return to the dark side if you discovered your real identity.
But now you know the truth, Revan. The Council has failed in their attempt to make you their pawn. The will of a Sith Lord is not so easily manipulated.
First Malak betrayed me, and now you and the Jedi.
How can you say that? Malak nearly killed you, but the Jedi Council gave you another chance to live. They gave you a chance to redeem yourself by defeating the Sith.
Regardless, Malak, your reign is at an end.
The Jedi Council were foolish to let you live. I won't make the same mistake. We shall finish this alone in the ancient Sith tradition. Master versus apprentice, as it was meant to be. Imagine my surprise when I found out you were still alive. How you survive the final battle is a mystery to me.
I'll gladly show you.
A rash and futile hope.
Bastila. Why? Why didn't you tell me?
But now fate has given me a second chance to prove myself. Once I defeat you in combat, no one will question my claim to the Sith throne. My triumph will be complete.
You seem to forget, Malik, that you were once my apprentice. I remember now. I'm the one who cut off your jaw for mouthing off.
The dark side is too strong. My power is too great. Even my old master is no longer a match for me. You are the one who taught me the ways of the Sith. The strongest must rule if we are to survive. Once I served you, Revan, but I always knew that one day the title of Dark Lord would be mine.
You forgot one thing, Malik.
This isn't over, Malik.
Your friends do not give up easily, Revan. You always could inspire loyalty.
For the Jedi! I'll hold Malik off. You two get out of here. Find the Starforge.
No, Bastila, he's too strong.
No!
Bastila!
The door's sealed. We can't get past. Come on, we have to get to the Ebon Hawk.
The Ebon Hawk? What? No, wait. What about Bastila? We can't leave without her, Karth.
Bastila doesn't stand a chance against Malik, but we can't help her. Not here.
I'm not leaving Bastila behind.
We have to get off the ship and find the Star Forge. That's the key to beating the Dark Lord.
I know that, but it's just
Bastila
we can't...
sacrificed herself so we could get away. We can't let her sacrifice be in vain. Come on!
Candris, fire up the ship!
Let's get moving again.
Hyperdrive's down. Can you fix it? All right, then let's move. We've got company. Candris, get to the turrets.
Right. One more time.
All right, T3. Don't worry, Big Z. He'll do his thing.
I need a better weapon!
Come on, T3, old buddy. Don't let me down. Candris, watch the port side.
Revan, tell me, why did the Jedi spare you?
Get out of my head.
Now you know the truth, Revan.
Yes.
You cannot hide from what you once were, Revan.
Yes. Now I know the truth. I am Revan.
This one's gone!
It's time to go. T3, bring it in.
Thank you.
shouldn't have left her. This is all my fault. We have to regroup.
Not so fast. We've got a bigger issue to deal with here. They deserve to know the truth about you. Do you want to tell them what Malik said, or should I?
We cannot jeopardize this mission by telling them, Karth. Not yet. We've come too far. Please.
The Sith bombed my homeworld, Revan took away my family, and destroyed my life.
Even now, you refer to Revan as a different person. Regardless of what Malik said, I am still Logan Starr. Haven't I proven myself to you? It should not matter that I...
Of course it still matters. How do we know more memories won't come flooding back? How do we know Revan won't suddenly turn on us? The whole time we've been chasing after Malik, we've had his old Sith master right at our side, listening to our secrets, hearing our plans.
And yet I brought us this far, Karth. I have been loyal to you and the others.
I suppose you've proven yourself to be a friend of the Republic by your actions so far, Revan. But can I trust you? Can any of us?
Bastila trusted me. Now I'm asking you.
Where is Bastila? What happened on that ship?
We ran into Malik. He would have killed us, but Bastila sacrificed herself so we could get away.
You mean she's dead?
Bah, Malik won't kill her. Don't be foolish. He'll want to use her battle meditation against the Republic. Turn her to the dark side, and the Sith will always be victorious.
Regardless, we have to come up with a game plan. There's a Republic station orbiting the nearby planet of Yavin. We should probably go there.
So I guess that's it then. We keep going. I guess we just have to find a way to push forward.
Yes. Yes, we do. Captain Drace, you took some tracking down. I'm glad to see you are safe. It says here you're near Paragus. You've left Manan, have you?
Yes, Logan. I couldn't stay there any longer. I love the Republic. I would die for it. With the war spinning out of control, I felt my abilities were being wasted there on that watery rock. Being away from the action, it was like not being true to myself. Like I was almost leading a different life. Does that make sense?
More than you know.
And now, with the tragedy on Dantooine, I... well...
So it is true. Dantooine is destroyed.
Yes. The Sith fleet laid to waste its surface. The Jedi Enclave, and all who were in it, were lost.
There must be some survivors, Seth.
Well, luckily some Jedi and a few of the Masters were off-planet during the strike. But anyone who was there, and trust me, Logan, I've seen the Holo report. They could not have survived.
I cannot believe that, Seth. I refuse to believe it. I have to go there.
I understand. But if you go there, I fear you will not find what you are looking for. I fear you will find much worse.
I am experiencing something unusual, Master. My programming is activating my deleted memory core.
What's that mean?
It seems that the homing system deliberately restores my deleted memory core upon returning to my original master.
You mean you know who I am?
Correct, Master. Sith protocols maintain that all droid knowledge be deleted before assassination missions and restored upon return.
So my revelation became yours. Revan once... I once owned you.
It is a distinct pleasure to see you again, Master.
Right. Well, you can't tell the others.
Yes, Master. You seem to have forgotten much. But in some ways, you seem improved from the human I once knew. It is difficult to explain, Master.
So am I still that Master of old? Am I still the Revan you once knew?
Observation. In many ways you are, Master, yes. You have much of the beloved cruelty of the Master I knew.
Am I not different, though? Haven't I changed?
You are different in many fundamental ways, Master. You have a concern for life. That is unsettling. This cannot solely be caused by memory loss. I do not know how to explain it. Regardless, you do seem to be improved, overall, from the human I once knew.
Huh. I guess that gives me a little comfort. can't believe Malik was my apprentice.
Commentary. Your former pupil is efficient and brutal, even for an organic. If I had known what he would do to you, Master, I would have gladly removed his entrails right then.
Well, that's very kind of you, HK. But Malik's mine. For now, let's focus. Let's go to Dantomy. I'll deal with Malik soon enough.
Observation. Now that is the Master I remember.